Fire Operations Manager Anderson was notified via telephone by Deputy Chief Nokes at 8:26 a.m. on September 4th, 2019, that the Martin Marietta Quarry in Williamsport contacted him, stating they believed they had located a missing dog within the quarry. Due to the location and no access to the dog, special operations would need to respond to begin a technical rescue of the dog. Several teams, along with an off-duty DES FF2 technician, Olson, reported to the scene. Upon arrival at the bottom of the quarry with Bob Foreman, the dog was located on the second bench down, approximately 150 feet up from the bottom of the quarry and 100 feet below the edge of the quarry. At this point, Anderson determined the best point to set up a rescue attempt was from the top, and they would conduct a lowering, rappelling operation. Anderson designated one of the utility members, McCoy, to be the only one calling out commands and declared the threshold for PPE to be from the power pole to the edge, approximately 5 feet. At this point, a radio was given to Rescuer 2, but not Rescuer 1. Rescuer 1 then began to descend over the edge. Approximately 25 to 30 feet down, Rescuer 1 called out, "Stop!" And he had to place edge protection over a knife's edge ledge, rubbing the rope where the slope transitioned into the vertical. This locked the system in place. Rescuer 2 then began his descent over the edge. Approximately 15 feet down, Rescuer 2 traversed loose rubble and subsequently sent several boulder-sized rocks downward. Rescuer 2 yelled down to Rescuer 1 to look out. At this time, Rescuer 1 yelled up to Rescuer 2, advising that he was hurt. Rescuer 2 yelled up to the topside and relayed the message. About 30 seconds later, Rescuer 2 said that Rescuer 1 thought he had broken his leg, was bleeding badly, and had busted his finger. At this point, Anderson contacted communications, relaying that they had an injured rescuer. Rescuer 2 remained on the rope in the same position out of fear that more loose rock would fall and hit Rescuer 1 again. Attempts were made to get Rescuer 1 bleeding control supplies, but they were unsuccessful. Rescuer 1 requested to be hoisted up about 2 to 3 feet to reposition out of the vertical and back onto the slope. Rescuer 1 began to self-rescue, and topside personnel assisted by hauling. Rescuer 1 was placed in a Stokes basket, and Chisholm began a trauma assessment. Minutes after, Rescuer 1 was loaded into the back of the ambulance and transported to Meritus. At about 11:20 a.m., Hagerstown Fire Department received a request for assistance of rope technicians and a ladder truck from Deputy Chief Nokes, a Williamsport volunteer fire and EMS company, to aid in the ongoing high-angle rescue of a dog. B.C. Hopkins approved the request and responded on Truck 4 with four other rope rescue technicians. Fire apparatus operators Cory, Daniel Garnand, Zachary Schmidt, and Russell Gutshall at 11:37 a.m. Due to the topography of the scene, additional rescue attempts would result in potential landslides of loose rock onto responders on rope. The crew determined that if they could get a ladder truck up to the quarry and extend the aerial out, they could clear both upper shelves while lowering the rescuer, reducing the potential for a landslide collapse. However, there was only a narrow off-road lane into where they were working and no truck access to the lane. After discussion with the Martin Marietta representative on scene about ladder truck access, it was decided to cut away three sections of fence and widen the existing lane with brush removal to provide ladder truck access as close to the quarry ledge as possible. Quarry staff also offered to lay down stone to provide a road for the truck. They responded with large front-end loader and two dump trucks of stone. Once the site prep was completed, HFD moved Truck 4 into position. This required cutting an old power line out of the way with a Hurst cutter. The rigging for lowering and hauling was constructed. Gutshall was placed on rope and the system loaded. To achieve the goal of clearing the shelves, the aerial was extended with the rescuer attached, with the lowering team and the turntable operator, Lescalleet, working in tandem. Once access was made to Wesson's level, Gutshall came off rope and retrieved Wesson. During this time, the rigging team changed out from a lowering operation to a haul operation. HFD was within about 20 feet to the end of a 300-foot rope bag. After Gutshall and Wesson were on the line, the system was loaded and the haul team began to haul. The tagline aided in bringing Gutshall and Wesson over to the edge to be removed from the system. After the rescue was completed, Wesson was reunited with his family and taken to the emergency veterinarian.